Hello guys, welcome back to some more Country Kid Gaming as we continue playing some more Shadow of the Erdtree. This is the Mage playthrough, so we're gonna hop on here as we fancy. Need some horns. We did switch our character back to some better stats. We're not gonna use that staff. We need the sorcery skeleton to be over 300. Has to be. What level are we now? 14. Shadow Blessing. Go ahead to the Ruah base. I think it's the Temple Town ruins and stuff like that. We already fought the bear that was over there. Looks like we pick up that item. That's Bonnie Village. Everything down there. There's more ruins, at least that. We already went up there. Good. Okay. So we can go in here. Yeah, we probably just came and picked it up. These items that was in here. The water and the hole down there. I think.
Thank you.
nothing, almost nothing found in the Land of Shadow is the same thing that's found in the Lands Between, because I can't find none of the materials, you know what I mean? So it seems like if I want to find some of these materials, I have to go back to the Lands Between. I won't be able to find them here. There's only a couple items you can find here, and it's mostly from animals, like thin bones and beast bones and meat and stuff like that. Which one is it? That's my camera cord. Okay, so it's you. Yeah, some plug. Let's see my CPU. The only thing I really need to plug is my capture card and my mouse. And the speakers. I don't think that I have plugged it. My CPU usage usually doesn't go over 1.2, it's usually below 1% on OBS. That's how I know I'm doing. I got a great computer. I got a very good laptop. It's a Yoga. Not to be confused with the Leisure Time event. Would you consider it Leisure Time, or would you consider it exercise? I guess yoga would be considered exercise. Some people might say leisure. Some you might do for fun. You know, for exercise. Might as well go ahead and get the map. We'll come back and do that. I think there's a forge that way. The message. I think this is the way with a pistol. That was uncalled for. I don't know if I can make this distance. Better if you were a fragment. In this way. That was the Taylew's dude. What's the way to keep going? Another way to take them to the ruins. I think this is going to give me the better version. I'll go this way and try it. It's either that or the beaker or something. Can't remember off the top of my head. To another bear. Get this side of Grace real quick. This path basically prepares you where to come inside the ancient ruin area. So there's a whole bunch of these types of pests over there. Though other than what they drop, I don't think there's any difference in these pests than the other ones. I think they may drop some new materials. That's about it. They're not like the imps that drop two new weapons. I kind of wonder why they didn't drop another type of glaive, like one that did more rot than the original one, or something that did like bleed and rot together, but I guess no point in doing that, so. I think it's just an horned warrior over here too. One of the greatest ash boar ever. Here, hiding. Thank you. do that because it was a side of grace right there. So. At least this keeps you from not having to do the pest every single time. Once you clear the area. Now, I can't remember what this one is called. I know there's like Ravala is one of the red bears. The other one starts with like a G, I believe. It's not a weird name, it's just a certain sound. Hello, friends. Yes, give me the horns. I gotta go for more of those. Sucks that you can only have 10 at a time. I guess they figured that it'd be too OP to have your whole inventory there. So somebody go ahead and make a mod that way I can have the whole inventory there. This is for what, the big poison pot? No. Is it the big rock pot that we don't have yet? Or is there a big deadly poison that we're going to get? I don't know. This is also how you know there's going to be a red bear around. You see that? And these bears as well. I think these bears actually drop that too as well. I know the red bear doesn't drop it, but I think these are where you can farm that excrement at. What is it called? Horn Studio. These are horned bears. Too far away. For no reason. It would be cool if we could farm the red bears for the rooms, if they would just respawn. I know they some games have added where you can fight bosses again, but the mods that I've seen, none of them added something like a bonfire aesthetic. You have to go somewhere to fight them, but you don't really get any rewards too much for fighting them. You know, you don't get a lot of souls or anything. I don't think I've seen one in the Elden Ring mod yet, but I've seen some in like Dark Souls 3 and some other ones. So I would at least make it to where it's like Dark Souls 2 if you're going to do Elden Ring, you know what I'm saying? To where we get the same amount of rooms and the actual new game plus amount of rooms. Plus whatever the boss drop, you know what I'm saying? That would be dope. So somebody go ahead and do that. That's what I was thinking. There's another bear down here. This is your own weak point. Just imagine if I had two thorn sorcery staffs. What they call it, Staff of the Guilty? It's something weird like that. Just imagine though if I had two of those using the impenetrable thorns. It'd do some disgusting amount of damage. It's like there are catacombs or a grave over here too. Okay, so this is the right there. Seven more to go after this one. Yeah, we only have two now. Deadly poison. should be another bear outfit over here. The bear hunters. I can't remember where it is exactly. Take care of the woods part. Let's go back down. Just out of my sight. Take some scorpion moves. Really hoping you just drop me your liver. They're weaker than the fingerprint, but it's got more reach. This is where I picked up the potentate pot. Good right there. Maybe because it's late at night, but can't see the view they're talking about. I think this is the... Is it the Snake River, Viper River, or something? River Snake? Scorpion River. I don't know why I said that. And we just killed the scorpions. The fact that I'm wearing fingers is crazy. It's like a bunch of finger creepers poking out of my chest. I think this is another death knight though. Because I think there's two death knights in Geordi, right? Haven't been down here yet. If I remember correctly, that's what I think it is. Because you get two Death Knight weapons. I think there's only three catacombs. So I think it's two death knights in Geordi, if I remember correctly. This is the closest one to form for me to get this weapon. That's what I do on my other characters. There's nothing really special about it. Just like the other one, the strong attack shoots stuff out. Oh no, that one I think does fire. Can't remember. Thank you. has a baseball. I don't know why it's sitting there trying. Breaking my own logic. Sniping. So that's a good spell for long range. I think pretty much if you can lock on to him, you can. But now I'm too far away. So as soon as you can lock on, that's what you gotta do. Should work. What? It seems like I'm the same distance, but for some reason he's a little bit. I don't know, is this a fluke? I'm pretty sure I was the same distance when I hit that one. I mean, the distance is still good, but I thought for sure as soon as you lock on. Yeah. I don't know why. It must have been a fluke when I hit the other guy. Yeah, still a great distance, but I could have sworn I hit dude from all the way back here. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the angle. Blessed bones drop from both of these enemies. Yeah, but I could have swore as soon as you lock on, you could hit people with this, but I guess the first shot was a fluke. It seemed like I was at the same distance, but maybe I was just seeing things. Trying to make it. I don't think that would work, man. Up on my other character. It does 2 vigor. It's crazy because that wasn't in the on the wiki. Maybe it is now. But when I was looking up items I had missed, that is not one that popped up. Let's see if they updated it. Because I was like, okay. I'm pretty sure I had all the armor sets. Because, you know, they have it listed on them. So let me see if they updated it. Stop trying to get me to do good. It stinks. So where is it? Yeah, because I had checked it with the list they have on the wiki and on my other character, and I was like, yeah, I got all the armor sets. But it looks like they don't have this on here, so let me look to see if it's been updated. I think it's because they don't have it as an armor set. Helms is probably what I should have looked at to see if there was something that was separate. That's what it is, because I know you can get the Miklas helm after beating the boss. We already got that one, so that's probably what it is. It's not listed on armor sets. It probably says as helms only. I forgot to even click on that, because it's the same thing with Saint Trina's Blossom. Yeah, so it looks like the lion head's the last thing I'm missing when it comes to headpieces. Okay, let me look at chest pieces. I never thought about it to look at them separately. See if I was missing something. Not missing that. Let's look at balance, and then we'll look at legs real quick. Not that hard to see there. Most likely it would just be chest pieces or helm pieces would be the only thing that are separate. Usually don't find it's been a long time since you just found some gauntlets that do things. So I think Dark Souls 2 might have been the only one. But you can get those gauntlets that give you, basically you can get critical hits, regular attacks. But I don't think they do stuff like that anymore. It's mainly chest pieces or head pieces. And sometimes boots, I guess. Well, no. I think the cat boots, they were in Dark Souls 2. So I don't think there was any. But I'll just double check to make sure. Yeah, so I have to come back here in my main character and get this. Didn't we already have something else that boosts bigger? I have to check and see. It's a missile, so I think it goes pretty far. When I was killing the finger creepers, the one thing I learned about this spell, I don't know if I can show it here, it can go up. Yeah. It doesn't just stay on the ground, wherever your target is. I thought that was pretty good. This one has a base four. It's pretty disgusting. Seems like depending on where your target is, it can go a little bit farther. But if the target's on the ground, it'll probably just go to the ground. It's probably the hitbox of the move. Because it went farther up than it did farther forward, so I think if it was like a flying enemy, we would have been able to get a little bit more. It's gonna come back in. guess they just didn't want you to be able to stop the mods, because you can't hurt them statues. I tried before. I think that's the only weapons I'm missing on my other character is the mini hatch you can get for these imps in here, and then the headpiece. I think it's the only armor set I'm missing. Now that I checked that, the only thing else I'm missing is Ash of War and one talisman that I know of. It's one of the most annoying spots in this whole catacombs. Snipe, old boy. I mean, I got me. I don't know why. What? I know why I was doing it, because I was low on health, but I can just snipe, old boy. Slowly moves toward the enemy as well, so that also helps it be effective. He ran away. You got your friends to back you up, man, huh? No, Basculus. Basculus. I wonder how many people are trying to get that message. Yeah, I mean. He drops his axes, and then he drops this one right here. And I think that's it. Unless there's another one. No, those are the only two weapons he has. But the next one is Jordy, the catacombs. I don't think... spells were doing decent damage even without the... I don't know where the other catacomb is. I know where the last one is. This one is down. It was right here, yeah. Falkworth. 1, 2. That's the only catacombs I remember, I think. Let me check it out. Just make sure. Because I think it was just 2 Death Knights and... Yeah, unless there's a third one, I'm not remembering. Like catacombs, Scorpion River, Fogger catacombs. No, because I think it's 3 of each. I think it's 3 forges, 3 catacombs, 3 jails, 4 mausoleums. I think that's how they did it. Is it starting to slow down now? 5 plus. It goes up by 12. Yeah, I think after 41 it slows down. Because that only went up by 6. 5 to 42 went up. I mean, my bad. It went up by 7. Now it only went up by 6. going on. And I have a thorn staff. Let me go get one real quick. It's the fastest place. See if I get lucky. Hey, I need your staff. It's actually quite surprising. Why is he drop PC on? Oh, it shows like a second. Yeah, I'm gonna be a little more difficult than you wanna be, huh? I think I'm gonna do away with the shield for now. Another place. This is the beginning. Staff did that for us. That's a disgusting thing, like allowing the staff to like awaken. That would have been cool for having that as an Ash 4. Sort of how a spinning weapon actually does something with this weapon. That would have been dope to have that. I don't think that was it anyway. It looked like it was just a small item. Ceiling drop me. Alright, I'm gonna pause it. It might take me a while to get it. Okay, so it's 18 without the stab. And one hit. Let's see this one. Looks like 818 for just a straight up hit, but if I put off the staff, it just dropped from me. Took forever. Just put on the hood because I figured that that would have a little bit more help for me. I put it on this because it boosts my arcane a little bit, so I was like, maybe that'll help. I thought they might have updated this staff to the staff of the guilty. Might as well pick up this ash wound. Need to upgrade it for it to get the boost, so now if I had two of these, it'd be pretty disgusting. Make a build just around this spell. Well, no, there's three others, there's two other spells I can get. Okay, so this needs 24 faith. I wonder how much the other ones need. So yeah, and these staff pretty much, they don't need intelligence at all, so you can pretty much just rack up faith and use those spells and be disgustingly strong. I have two of them. I wonder if I want to do that for a while. Nah, cause that'll limit my spells for now. I won't do that. This way I have that on there. So now I got this boasting the fingerprints and this boasting that. So it's cool, and then there's no other, like I said, this doesn't boast the fingerprint. And the rest of my stuff is gravity spells, but there's no way a piece that boosts gravity. This that I know of. But this isn't my character that has everything, so I can't just check my inventory. These are the same thing. Endurance, arcane. Yeah, this is my character that has everything. And these do, you lose something for wearing these. Not this one though. Man, this one you lose something to. And I don't think the gravity staff is gonna be worth it since you can't upgrade it. I don't think the scaling gets that high on there, even though it's F scaling. Put that away for now. Yeah, it's only gonna be 258. It just uses too much FP. 11, 19. I might switch to it later on, but not right now. It'd be a pretty disgusting build. But for enemies that don't bleed, it might be tough to kill some of them. I don't know why she always wanted to use it. Put herself to sleep, my mimic. Guess we'll have to do that later because you're gonna disappear. Thank you. surprised with all the damage it does, because it's 369 for attack power. Maybe just because it's a staff, it won't actually do no real damage if you just hit people. Because usually a weapon that does 369 will do more damage than that, so. That's gotta be what it is. Too bad that only works on the throwing daggers that pierce and throw. That'd be OP to work on all Smith's grip weapons. Ignore my spirits. They be like, yeah, them spirits, we don't care about them. We gonna kill you, the summoner, and the spirit gonna go away. That's how they be thinking about it. I swear, that's what it be seeming like. First, let's see. How much FP I lose? Dang, I did it wrong. This guy ain't gonna stay still long enough for me to get that mask off. Down to get that item. Trying to see, you know, what's be better, this one or this one. Depends on how much FP that I heal without it. So, to see which one is better, because right now I have 242 for a hole, right? We just have to see how much HP I get for drinking a flask without any advancement. What's up there? That's a monument, right? Mausoleum? I believe the red bear, right? Where's the mausoleum up there? Interesting. I have to go my other map and see what is that one. Because I know what's all the way up there, but I can't remember what's there. Get this item down here first. It's probably just smithing stone. Got home worker. It's just my mimic is going, I might as well. It's ghosts. I mean grave, not even ghosts. I don't know if it's going to be useful, but let's just see what it is. Oh, never mind. It's like a dead bug. I gotta use the bathroom, might be open. Alright, your boy is back. Let's go kill that guy we missed. Guys, tell me you got some good juice on you. No, I wanted another fragment. Not helping me out. Yeah, this will take me to where I've already been. There wasn't anything in here, right? Sticks and stones, man. Sticks and stones. Isn't there a set of grace here too? I was just seeing things. Was it just this one? Maybe just that one. Maybe the map was the only thing that was over here. This leads me to the mausoleum. I don't remember what that is. I think that was just a mausoleum here, but there may have been something down below. I don't remember if you can take an elevator down, all the way down there to look out. Okay, doesn't look like nothing. think I can make this jump, but we'll see. Yeah. Okay. Hold on a second. Let me check the map. It may just be in the Ruah ancient ruins. You just have to crawl down. It's not a significant area. It doesn't pop up on the map. Okay, so there must be a way to get there. Is there another spirit spring this way? I'm gonna say there is another spirit spring on the other side. I think I'm remembering now. Because we did do the other spirit spring, we just got the chest and that was it. Spirit ashes, right? Like, I know it's not hard to reach. Yeah. Best one. To me, that's the best one. I get Anna and the other one. That one's okay because they do the bleeding and stuff, but I still think that's the best one. I think that's everything in this whole area. Now we just need to go the other way. There's a forge in the space up here. I never noticed this chest before. No, I have. I have that talisman. I was thinking about my other playthrough. I'm like, did I not notice this chest? No, I have that. the big one over here, right? This one might be good. If he drops 5 every time or just the first time. If he drops 5 every time, this would be the best place to farm the Sacred Blood. What it is, right? Okay. This may be the best place to farm it if he drops it every time. And as long as the flowers can keep being picked up. And this one drops a sacred fork, right? Be something nasty. I don't even want to look at the rest of them. Even like finger, you know what, and all that stuff. People so wild. came from right here. Only that pierced enemies too. Part of me thinks I should get rid of this one. Of this one? We'll have to wait and see. So, you know, these are the only talismans that you can basically double up on. It's the ones that increase sorcery's incantations. I mean, I guess you can do both of them arrow ones, but most things you can't double up on. It's just pretty good, nice to see that. This is technically not the same talisman. Takes three hits right now. Let's see if it makes too much of a difference. If it still takes three hits, then it's not gonna matter. Still took 3 minutes. When that fills my whole bar. At least for now. I don't know what it would be in the future. May not fill my whole bar anymore. This spell is weird sometimes. Sometimes it'll go after the target, sometimes it won't. It's just weird. It's too late. I wonder if it'll pop back up. Have to wait and see. something about the hitbox with this that's off, you know? Is it only the... I think it may be only the fingers that do damage and nothing else. I think if you're in the middle, it don't work. Something about the hitbox is off on the crushing fingers. I get it's called crushing fingers, but even when the person is getting hit by the fingers, if it's not at a certain angle, it completely misses, which is weird. To you. Hey, you're hearing me. So I got a smith of thorns. 9 and 7 did that. Appears to be everybody. I think I left anybody alive. To what it was. I like how these are, but I kind of do wish there was a boss, a new type of boss, that you know each of these. Like if the boss was optional. Beggars can't be choosers. Looks like it got 4 points on the sorcery skill. I can't. I don't. If it has a cookbook, I don't have it on this character. There, maybe just for decoration. These replace Tonos. What? Oh, I have gravity. The stats for it. Yeah. Could make this a frost one. And just use it. I guess I'll go across first. This Misgift Hammer and Shield and Axe is all over. Now I've used this before. This is gonna make me heavy load though. I don't got the stats for this in one hand yet. I do got the stats for this one, so. But I think the axe, the shield, and the Great Hammer are all in. Now it wants to do that. That's why I said this, it's kind of weird. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I won't fight both of y'all. Technically, there's four if you farm them for the fist weapons, but I don't need that on this game, so I won't do that. I wonder what game that is. Hopefully they don't kill me while I'm doing this. Oh, Tales of Iron. Thought about checking that out. It's like a rat souls like. A lot of good things in this one. This one is definitely Candyland. Just petting your little friend over there. They're so cute, not. There. only you can infuse this one, it would make it so much better. But since it's the special move is a discus throw. That's the only thing I don't like about it, that it's not like these. It's, you know what I mean? You can't actually, you can only throw it by using FP. You can't just throw it by using a strong attack. It kind of defeats the purpose, you know, of the shield. Because it doesn't really hit that hard. Like, this move is actually pretty strong if you buff it right, but... just the last interview. Guess I do need to go back and do this other forge. Do that next video though. Because that way I can, I'll probably replace this with the Smith script weapon. Not weapon, but a talisman. Oh, there's another enemy. Thought they were all gone. Thank you. Just do it after I do the next one. But I'm gonna hop over here and do this one. I'll see you guys in the next video. We can continue on with this journey, playing more of Shadow of the Erdtree, the Mage Run.